Hey YouTube, Tech Intimidation here with another quick tip. Three ways to share and collaborate using Dropbox. So there are multiple ways to share files using Dropbox. The first one is with a full folder or file in Dropbox, just right click and choose share link. That makes this file, that individual file, publicly available at a link that it's about to share with you. You can immediately share it if you fill in this form with an email. It will email that person with a link to this file. Or you can just click the Get Link button and it will copy it to your clipboard. Now at this file up here now, at this URL, this file is now publicly available at this URL. So you could text it, you can email it, Twitter, whatever you want to do. This file is now open to the world. The second way that you can share files, oh, and if you want to stop sharing it, you would click remove link, or if you just go back to your Dropbox, if you look under links here on the left, it will show you all the files that you currently have made publicly available, and if you want to stop it, just click the X. The second way is by sharing a folder. The way you do that is click the folder icon with a little rainbow, a happy rainbow on it. Click share, and you can create or share an existing folder. I'm going to make a new one called shared folder. And I'm going to share it with myself. And it does two things. It creates the folder to be shared, and it emails the person that you just shared it with. So let's check my other email account. And I received an email that says Tech Intimidation would like to share this folder with you. If I click it, it sends me to Dropbox. I just log in. And it says, you now have a shared folder. Just click accept. And now this folder appears in my Dropbox. It's currently empty. Now, I or the original creator of the folder, either one of us can put things in there and it becomes immediately available with the other person. So if I drop this folder or this photo in here, I can see it as myself. And if I go back to Tech Intimidation's side and look in the shared folder, that photo is now in there as well. So you can instantly share without a whole lot of fuss. That's kind of the nice feature of the shared folder. The third way is the less obvious way, and with new accounts this isn't available by default, but I have another video. If you click, I'll add an annotation. I have another video that shows you how to enable this feature, which is the public folder. With the public folder, it's basically a folder that is always publicly available to the world. So anything you put inside this public folder is immediately available to the world. And so what you would do with any file in here, once you put it in public, all you need to do is copy public link, and then you can email that to anyone. And it's doesn't matter if they have a Dropbox account or not, they can download it. And if your friend doesn't know how to download just a text link to a file, I have another video about that as well, and I will pop that in right here. And that's it. So there's multiple ways to share things using Dropbox, all of which are pretty simple. If you have any comments, please leave them below. Also, subscribe for more tech tips from Tech Intimidation. Thanks.